Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Market. Welcome to my kitchen. The beef brisket is essentially the chest or pectoral muscles. And with beef, they're supporting 60% of the animal's weight. A big job when you're pushing 1,800 pounds. Brisket may not be that fancy-smancy steak that gets all the glory, but hard-working muscles mean big flavor and serious satisfaction, especially when they're cooked nice and slow. Brisket is used quite differently from Texas to Thailand, but it's the classic Jewish recipes that keep me coming back, especially in the cooler months of the year. Hey, I may not be Jewish, but I know good cooking when I taste it. Sit back, join me in the kitchen as we explore the delicious brisket of beef. This is the whole beef brisket. These muscles support and move a lot of weight, so they're particularly heavily loaded with collagen, a cartilage or connective tissue that's like a scaffolding that holds the body together. The word brisket is actually derived from the Old Norse word for cartilage or collagen. Briskets take a lot of trimming. It's been a while, let's see if I can remember how. The biggest mistake I see is taking too much of the fat off. A thick layer on the back really helps the brisket cook better, and it slides off like a hot knife through butter after cooking. The brisket is made up of two muscles. I'm peeling this flat cut off. It's also known as the center cut. The flat cut is leaner and visibly more attractive, two obvious reasons for its popularity. This is the deckle, also known as the point cut. It's particularly loaded with collagen, forming the grain that we slice across. I think it's the best part of the brisket. All that collagen is so rich and satisfying, but most folks don't know about them, so we don't put deckles in the counter. But you can special order one if you like. This is how we trim briskets for our counters. We've left a modest layer of fat on the back and just a little of the deckle for flavor and to help balance thickness. I suggest making a point to taste that deckle section. It's amazing, but not for everybody. Vive la différence! For seasoning, I use a combination of our crazy seasoning salt and our pepper steak seasoning. Aside from peppercorns, it has bell pepper and crushed red pepper, so it's great for a lot more than pepper steak. I love this seasoning combination for all braised meats. Browning before cooking really works to deepen the flavor, but you can skip it if you like. I'm doing the flat cut and the half deckle in this roasting pan, so I'll brown it in the same pan. The rest of the deckle is going into the ceramic crock, so I'll put it in the heavy skillet. Once brown, we'll remove the meats and add vegetables. Looking more closely, the skillet browned better and created a better fond in the pan because I started with the meat fat side down, and because it's a heavy-duty skillet. I'll remember that for next time. Add a couple pounds of celery, carrot, and onion chunks, sautéing to build the next layer of flavor. The little deckle in the skillet is going a different way, so I slice the veggies more thinly, and there's less, it's just a smaller batch. The vegetables will caramelize, gaining more flavor as their moisture helps release the brown bits at the bottom of the pan. Once they start to brown, add a glass or two of red wine along with a small can of tomatoes. Any tomatoes will work, but I'm crazy about Italian baby or cherry tomatoes. They add bites of intense tomato flavor and look amazing. I'll also add a tablespoon and a half of garlic, a couple bay leaves, a teaspoon of thyme, and almost a half cup of ketchup, spicy or regular. Then we'll lay the brisket into the bottom of the pan, smother with the vegetables, and cover with a lid or parchment and foil. This baby is ready for the oven, about 5 to 6 hours at 275 degrees, convection fan on. I started this smaller brisket deckle in a skillet because we're cooking in a ceramic crock. If you're using an electric crock pot, the steps are exactly the same. Simply combine the brown meat and vegetables in the crock, and if you're in a hurry, you can skip the browning steps. I won't tell anyone. Speaking of keeping it simple, all we need is a jar of our osobuco and stew braising sauce and a little water. A whole jar is actually enough for a roast twice this size. Combined with the veggies, it's gonna make a world-class smothering sauce. Into a 275 degree oven, and I'll set the timer for 4 hours, but I expect the large pan to take at least 5 hours. Ideally, I want this done an hour or so before serving, giving me time to slice and display. Serving brisket is a great excuse to make latkes or potato pancakes. These are huge sellers in our delis. You can just take them home and warm them in the oven. Or to make them at home, start with about 2 pounds of russet potatoes. Peel and grate half of the potatoes coarsely and half finely. Also coarsely grate about a half pound of onion. We need to get as much water out as possible. I suggest using a colander, pressing on the shreds with a towel. This is better to do in the sink. You can also squeeze in a cloth tourniquet. Now we'll add 1 teaspoon of our crazy seasoning salt, 3/4 teaspoon of our medium grind pepper, 4 to 5 tablespoons of flour, and 1 egg. Toss together well and evenly, and we're ready to cook. Historically, latkes are fried in schmaltz, rendered chicken fat, which must taste amazing. I don't use vegetable oils anymore, so I rendered the fat I cut off the brisket for frying. It turned out great, but corn or canola oil would definitely be easier. Use a heavy pan for frying and enough oil to submerge the pancakes halfway up the sides. You can also use a deep fat fryer. Gently shape the pancakes by hand. The goal is thin cakes of even thickness, and small is better than big. Be really careful when you're turning these over. They want to flop over and splash hot oil up your arm and in your face. Turn carefully using the sides of the pan or another cake to avoid splashes. For great frying results, work to keep the oil at 360 to 420 degrees. You can test with a deep fryer or laser thermometer. Automatic temperature control is the big advantage of a deep fryer or electric skillet. Frying is not as simple as you might think. Temperatures soar when the pan is low and they drop fast when you add more food. The best way to manage this is to rotate new pancakes in when the others are about half done. Just keep this up until they're all fried. I kept the salt light on the inside so I can put salt on the outside right when they come out of the oil. This will make them more crispy and leave each bite with a hint of salt on the tongue. Of course, they're best right out of the fryer, but I make them several hours ahead, warming the oven right before serving. It just makes supper time simpler. Or you can buy these at Tony's. Just call 1 to 2 days ahead to order. They're traditionally served with sour cream or applesauce, but I also like spicy ketchup. It's been about 4.5 hours, so let's check the small brisket. We're looking for what they call fork tender, but who trusts a fork? Just cut yourself a little bite and taste it. Let's get it out to cool a little before slicing. In the meantime, we're going to finish the vegetable sauce. You can use a blender or a food processor, but an immersion blender is the easiest. Move the pan to the sink and puree. This is why the sink is so handy. If you splash a little out, no problem. For a thinner sauce, add a little water. Trust me, there's plenty of flavor even if you add water. Now we're ready to slice. Gently cut off the outside fat and identify the muscle grain direction. We want to slice across that grain. Slice thinly and patiently. It's tender enough to shred, but slices are worth a few extra minutes. Now line a serving pan with sauce, top with a layer of meat, and repeat for a second and third layer as needed. Layering the meat in sauce allows it to absorb juices back into the slices. You could also make this ahead, chill, slice, smother, and store in the refrigerator until you're ready to warm and serve. The big pan of brisket was done in about 5.5 hours, and it turned out great. First, we'll separate the meat and the vegetable and get it sliced. I move the meat to a cutting board and the vegetables to a bowl on the side. Just like before, identify the muscle grain direction so we can cross-cut that grain, increasing the tenderness. Then remove the fat from the backside and start slicing across the grain. Again, take your time and try to get full slices that are nice and thin. Slicing on a bias can increase your slice size. Let's use the same trick here to boost the juiciness of these lean, flat-cut slices, laying them or slathering them with the sauce to boost their juiciness and flavor. Finally, we'll pile the vegetables along the sides of the pan. These vegetables could also be pureed into a sauce, just like in our other dish if you like. Both ways are excellent. This dish turned out great. It was buttery tender. The flavors were huge and fabulously satisfying. A perfect pair with a big red wine, a fresh salad, and a rustic loaf of bread. And our latkes, of course. I really hope you get to make this someday. Now let's compare the flat cut with the deckle or point. This is the deckle, and this is the flat cut. All that collagen makes the deckle much richer and juicier. I love that, but it's not for everybody. We keep the leaner flat cuts in the counter every day. If you want a deckle, just order ahead and we'll get you some. Heck, I may even come over and help you eat it.
It may not be expensive, fancy, or glamorous, but the beef brisket is darn tasty. Why not bring a brisket home this month? I know your loved ones are gonna thank you. I'm Chef Mick Rosacci. I thank you for shopping in our markets, and I thank you for joining me in my kitchen.